Good morning. Our processional hymn is number 287. Number 287. We will sing verses 1 through 4. Service continues on page 3 of the service bulletin. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, whose blessed Son came into the world that he might destroy the works of the devil and make us children of God and heirs of eternal life, grant that, having this hope, we may purify ourselves as he is pure, that when he comes again with power and great glory, we may be like him in his eternal and glorious kingdom, where he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
The first reading is from the book of Job. Oh, that my words were written down. Oh, that they were inscribed in a book. Oh, that with an iron pen and lead, they were engraved on a rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and at the last he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has thus been destroyed, then in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see on my side, and my eye shall behold, and not another. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll read Psalm 17, responsibly using the asterisk. Hear my plea of innocence, O Lord. Give heed to my cry. Let my vindication come forth from your presence.
Let your eyes be fixed on justice.
Weigh my heart. Summon me by night.
Melt me down. You will find no purity in me.
I give no offense with my mouth as others do.
I have heeded your words on your lips.
My footsteps hold fast in the ways of your law. I call upon you, O God, for you will answer me. Show me your marvelous loving kindness, O Savior of those who take refuge at your right hand from those who rise up against them. Keep me as the apple of your eye.
Hide me under the shadow of your wings.
From the wicked who assault me.
The second reading is from Thessalonians. As to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our being gathered together to him, we beg you, brothers and sisters, not to be quickly shaken in mind or alarmed, either by spirit or by word or by letter, as though from us, to the effect that the day of the Lord is already here. Let no one deceive you in any way. For that day will not come unless the rebellion comes first and the lawless one is revealed, the one destined for destruction. He opposes and exalts himself above every so-called God of God, declaring himself to be God. Do you not remember that I told you these things when I was still with you? But we must always give thanks to God for you, brothers and sisters, beloved by the Lord, because God chose you as the first fruits for salvation through sanctification by the Spirit and through belief in the truth. For this purpose, he called you through our proclamation of the good news, so that you may obtain the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. So then, brothers and sisters, stand firm and hold fast to the traditions that you were taught by us, either by word of mouth or by our letter. Now may our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who loved us and through grace gave us eternal comfort and good hope, comfort your hearts and strengthen them in every good work and word. The word of the Lord.
Thanks
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Some Sadducees, those who say there is no resurrection, came to Jesus and asked him a question. Teacher, Moses wrote for us that if a man's brother dies, leaving a wife but no children, the man shall marry the widow and raise up children for his brother. Now, there were seven brothers. The first married and died childless. Then the second and the third married her, and so in the same way, all seven died childless. Finally, the woman also died. In the resurrection, therefore, whose wife will the woman be? For the seven had married her. Jesus said to them, "Those who belong to this age marry and are given in marriage. But those who are considered worthy of a place in that age and in the resurrection from the dead neither marry nor are given in marriage. Indeed, they cannot die anymore because they are like angels and are children of God, being children of the resurrection. And the fact that the dead are raised, Moses himself showed in the story about the bush, where he speaks of the Lord as the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Now, he is God not of the dead, but of the living, for to him, all of them are alive." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. Today is the first Sunday in November, so the church continues to celebrate All Saints' Day, the feast day that is officially on the calendar for November 1st. In just a few minutes, we will light some candles and pray special prayers for our departed loved ones. Many of us have brought pictures of them or some tokens of remembrance and placed them around the altar rail this morning. This is a visual reminder of their ongoing life with God and of their ongoing presence with us. In the church, we have a name for this eternal community of love and presence. We call it the Communion of Saints. The Communion of Saints is our way of expressing the eternal reality of our union with God and with each other. We are one, always have been, always will be, regardless of how contrarily some of us may choose to think and act sometimes. We are eternally one with God and with each other, the communion of saints. We are one, and we will be one forever. So really, don't you think we might as well start practicing right now? I think so. Anyway, it's rather perfect that our gospel reading this morning has Jesus talking about the resurrection. Luke presents us with an amazing exchange between Jesus and some Sadducees who do not believe in the resurrection or in any kind of life after death. And that's why they were sad, you see. Here it is. Yeah. Don't forget now. Right, so these very Sadducee people who do not believe in the resurrection, they came to present Jesus with a kind of double bind, no win, actually pretty ridiculous question. And sadly, as is so often the case, they are not trying to engage in any kind of theological debate with him. That would have been far too nice.
but they were trying to trap him, or perhaps just make him look like an idiot in public. And as always, Jesus wins the day. And in the process, he gives us an amazingly beautiful teaching on the resurrection, from bad to beautiful in the blink of an eye with Jesus. So, based on the ancient Mosaic law, the Sadducees proposed a ridiculous hypothetical situation. And Jesus answered by basically telling them that they just don't get it. They don't get it. They don't understand the way that God works, and especially not with regard to life and death. Jesus says that those who have died are, quote, like the angels and are the children of God, end quote. How beautiful. And how consoling, especially to those of us who have lost people that we love to death. And those of us who may be fast approaching our own deaths, which is all of us, I might add, how very beautiful and consoling the words of Jesus are. All Saints Sunday is a wonderful time each year to remember that we are all supported by the love and prayers of others who have already gone home to God before us. So many others. From our loved ones in eternity whose love never dies, because love can never die, because God is love, to those who accompany us on this side of eternity, including all the people in this church. All our love and prayers stretch across the temporary boundaries and very thin veils between heaven and earth, time and eternity, life and death, holding all of us close, very close together in the heart of God. It's a great way to remember every day to remember this, because especially on the hard days, we need it. We need to remember that we never have to do this alone. We never have to do this alone. We always have God, and we always have each other, the communion of saints. When I was on retreat a couple of weeks ago, my retreat started, as it so often does, with a little life review, a little looking back. And I had a really wonderful and fun and deeply moving time thinking about some of the people who have been my own spiritual mentors and guides and really deeply loved companions in this life. Some of my personal communion of saints. It's a beautiful prayer practice. Like my devout church lady mother, who ended up turning me into a church lady after all, against all odds, I might add. I'm sure she's probably quite pleased with herself. Like my nature mystic dad, who taught me to see God's presence shining out of every bee and tree and flower and bird and creature and animal and sunrise and sunset, all wind and water, every snow and rain and thunderstorm. Like my very traditional and kindly grandparents. Like Bishop Tom Shaw from Massachusetts, whose quiet holiness mentored me from being a Roman Catholic to being an Episcopalian, to being an Episcopal priest. Like Father Joe McHugh, an elderly Jesuit who directed my first ever silent retreats way more than 24 years ago. On my very first retreat ever, Father Joe gave me one of the most important pieces of advice that I have ever received about the spiritual life. He said, "Don't put anything between you and God. Don't put anything between you and God." And I never have, and I never will. And consequently, there isn't anything between me and God. Which is pretty cool. thanks to Father Joe. I thought about all these wonderful people and so many more, and I found myself swimming in gratitude for each and every one of them. And during my joyfully grateful prayers for them, I had a really fun and a really kind of profound thought. Perhaps because it was very close to Halloween, I realized how blessed I am to have had God come to me dressed up, disguised, costumed as all those people. All those really wonderful, wise, fun, feisty, crazy, holy people. How blessed am I? How blessed are we all to have them in our lives forever? The communion of saints. All those who God chooses to dress up as in order to love us through this life and on back home into eternity. You know, I've often been accused of being a little overly optimistic, of wearing rose-colored glasses. But here's the thing. How can I not be overly optimistic? How can anyone who actually believes all this stuff not be overly optimistic? Unless you want to not believe it and be a Sadducee person. And that's your choice, I suppose, but I can't for the life of me see why anyone would choose that. In today's gospel, Jesus says that after our bodies die, we cannot die anymore because we are like angels and we are the children of God. Being children of the resurrection, Jesus says. I love that. Jesus says that we are the children of the resurrection. He also says that God is God of the living, not the dead. Because to God, all are alive. All are alive, all of us. Now, there's a really nice line from the scriptures in support of universal salvation. If you're ever looking for one, and there are lots of other ones, of course, but that's a good one, and it comes right from Jesus. Comes right from Jesus. And so, my sisters and brothers, let's start acting like who and what we really are. Let's start acting like who and what we are called to be for one another and for everyone else in the world. Let's start acting like the communion of saints. Let's start acting like those who know that God is running around loose in the world, dressed up like all of us. Like all of us. So don't be sad, you see. Start living like a child of the resurrection, because that's who you are. That's who we all are. The communion of saints. Amen.
Now I'd like to invite us into a ritual of remembrance, prayer and remembrance, and candle lighting in honor of our departed loved ones. So this morning we will omit the Apostles' Creed, we will omit the prayers of the people, and we will omit the confession. And so I would ask you to please remember to pray for everyone who is on our parish prayer list. Bring it home with you, put it in your prayer space, tuck it into your Bible, and pray for them all week long as we always do. Thank you for that. You all have an insert on a yellow piece of paper, which contains our prayer. These prayers are adapted and very close to the prayers in the Book of Common Prayer. We will pray through part of the three-quarters of the page. Then I'll invite us to come forward into a candle lighting ritual. So we will. I'll hand you each a taper as you come forward. I'm having you lighted off already lit candles in this large bowl here. And I would like it really very much if we would take our time with this. So come forward as you wish at that time. Light the candle and stay here as long as you want. Say a prayer, speak their names, do whatever is meaningful to you. And then the next person will come behind you. Dave will play some beautiful music as we go. Let's just find ourselves deeply in the communion of saints together as we do this lovely ritual. My sisters and brothers in Christ, let us pray together in peace and gratitude for all our loved ones who have already gone home to God. For our departed brothers and sisters, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, "I am resurrection and I am life." Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn and dry the tears of those who weep.
Hear us, Lord.
You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow.
Hear us, Lord.
You raised the dead to life. Give to our brothers and sisters eternal life.
Hear us, Lord.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brothers and sisters to the joys of heaven.
Hear us, Lord.
Our brothers and sisters were washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give them fellowship with all your saints.
Hear us, Lord.
They were nourished with your body and blood. Grant them a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom.
Hear us, Lord.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our brothers and sisters. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Creator of all, we pray to you for all those we love but see no longer. Grant to them eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. May their souls and the souls of all the departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Amen. Please come forward.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who by the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light, grant that all our departed loved ones, being raised with Christ, may know the strength of his presence and rejoice in his eternal glory, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Would you please stand as you wish? My sisters and brothers, the peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of God's peace. Please be seated for some announcements and special blessings. What announcements need to come from the congregation this morning? Okay, no, take your time.
All right, no tears anymore. Okay, we're going to have fun Thursday night at our first game night of the fall and winter, and it's at 5:30. And what happens there is we have a sign up for soup or sandwich, and we eat this light supper, and then everybody, I bring lots of games, and people bring games, card games, board games, dominoes, and we all kind of just divide up and play games for a couple hours and keep our minds engaged. So that's one announcement. So the sign-up is in the parish hall, and it's this Thursday, so it's short notice, but I hope some of you will participate. It is a lot of fun. Secondly, the sign-up is in the hall for our annual meeting. We'll need people to bring breakfast casseroles and fruit and some pastries, some deviled eggs, of course. And so please sign up for that. And the third one was in this Wednesday announcement. And that, I'm bringing my pocketbook up here because my thing is in there to read. Susan Callahan, who's a member of our congregation, teaches at Del Tech in Dover. And they're going to do a buffet, early Thanksgiving buffet, and it's $12. And she's kind of reserved some spaces for people in St. Martha's. So if you would like to go, I'm going to take the sign up into the Great Hall. We can carpool up there. It's on November 18th at 11:30, and the cost is $12. And I think it would be fun to see what these young people are doing in the culinary program up there and to support Susan in what she's doing. So if you're interested, please go and sign up.
Thank you, Nancy. Lee?
Good morning, and good morning. I've got a sign up out in the parish hall for the Christmas cookie sale. And we don't wrap them up, we bring them in on trays or something, because we sell them by the pound. We had to up the price to $12 a pound this year, because everything is so high. And we can bring them in, like all kinds of cookies. You can also have special holiday loaves, jams or jellies, or cookie kits and jars, and some pies. And we can bring them in on the 9th, that's Friday, between 10 and 12, and 2 and 4. And remember, don't package up the cookies, but put them in a tray and then maybe put saran or plastic wrap over them, and then we will sell them that way. And if you're bringing something that you want to get back, make sure your name's on the tray. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Lee. Quincy.
Hello. I'd like to try and have another brick blessing before the end of the year. So, it's a good thing to ask first, isn't it? I have about 5 orders so far. So if you would like to put an engraved brick outside, the forms are right before the office. They're sitting there, and I'll try and remember now to take a few into the parish hall. It's $100. Just fill it out and give your check and your form to Jacqueline. She will get it to me, and then I will get the bricks engraved. Thank you.
Thank you, Wincy.
Try and do it quickly so I have time to do this. Thank you.
And Ron.
I don't have any sign-up list. But I want to commend everybody who has signed up for pledging. Last year we had 12 new pledges. This year we already have 19, and we are still going strong. We have surpassed the total amount pledged from last year, and we got time to go, so keep those letters and cards coming. Secondly, we have the men's breakfast this Wednesday, and so it starts at 9:15, so that change in time a little bit, so that. But you're encouraged, if you come, to bring fruit or vegetables or something, because our speaker is going to be John, our own John McKelvey, and so you want to make sure you have something to throw at him.
Boy, thank you. And just one for me, this coming Saturday, so next Saturday, we will celebrate Bryce Turner's funeral here at St. Martha's at 10 o'clock in the morning, 10 a.m. this coming Saturday. Are there any special birthdays or anniversaries or upcoming surgeries or travels to be blessed today? Come on up. We'll mind the fire. Hi. Birthday, okay, excellent. Okay, excellent. I'm just say a little bit, just so everybody can see you too, Marianne. Oh, I'm sorry. I think that's perfect. Okay, excellent. Birthdays. Later this month and surgery. When's your surgery? What day? Okay. Just. There's no such thing as a just when it comes to a surgery. When it's your body. There's no just. All right, I'll tell you what. Let's pray for Mary first, and then we'll pray the birthday blessing. Yeah? Gracious God, pour down your blessing upon our sister Mary. Be with her as she faces this surgery. We pray that all the medical professionals who touch her do so with great skill and great compassion. We pray that everything is successful, that her healing is quick and complete, and that she comes back to us at at St. Martha's as quickly as possible, all back together. In Jesus' name we pray. Okay, good luck with it. Ooh. Too much trying not to cry going on here today. Our birthday blessing is at the bottom of page 9. And let's pray together. Oh God, our times are in your hands. Look with favor, we pray, on your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace, and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their lives through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you all. It is time now for us to bring our gifts to the altar. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and a gift to God.
There are
on page 10 in the service bulletin. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sin. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever.
Amen.
Because Jesus is our brother, we have the courage to call God our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory
forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
These are the gifts of God for all of us who are the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ lived and died and rose again for you. Here at St. Martha's, we believe that this church is the house of God and this altar is the table of Christ. And so everyone is welcome to join us for Holy Communion. post-communion prayer is found on page 17. And let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Two things before the final blessing. First of all, I'd like to thank Alicia. Thank you so much for your beautiful music. Thank you. And also just a reminder that our grief is holy. Our grief is holy. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
and one another. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.